This video is going to show you how to use CrossOver's bottle management tool to work with archives. It's a pretty nifty feature of CrossOver, and so let's go ahead and get started. I'll just click on CrossOver, and then under Configure, I'm going to fire up our bottle management tool. And under the Advanced tab, you'll see here that we have a button called Make Archive. And we also have Add from Archive down at the bottom. So the first thing I want to show you is how to make an archive. The thing that is neat about archives is what we're doing is we're taking all of the underlying file structure for a given bottle and we're compressing it into a single file. So that file can be very easily moved around. You know, you can put it on a flash drive, you can back it up, you can take it with you. And then you can take it to another CrossOver machine and unpack it, and you've essentially installed that application on that new machine. So it's a very convenient way of making applications portable, if you will. So to make an archive, all I have to do is select the bottle that I want to be the archive, and in this case I'm just going to select eSword, and then tell CrossOver Make Archive. Now, this may take a while, depending on how big the application is, but eSword is relatively small, so it shouldn't take us very long to make this happen. And so it's asked me, okay, where do you want to save this archive and what name do you want to give it? I'm just going to go ahead and call it eSword, and I'm going to put it on my desktop. So hit the Save button, and ba-boom, that was very fast. You can see that it created an archive here called eSword and put it out on my desktop. And if I were to do a get info on that, I would see that this particular archive file is a grand total of about 54 meg. So restoring an archive is similarly quite simple. I have another one out here for Internet Explorer 6. So if I wanted to add an archive to this machine, all I would do would be to hit the Add from Archive button. And CrossOver will ask me, well, which archive would you like to unpack? I'm going to go ahead and tell it, hey, I want my IE6 bottle back. And I'm going to, it'll ask me if I want to rename that bottle. No, I'm just going to go ahead and create it as its name, IE6. And so what's happening now is CrossOver is unpacking that bottle structure and is installing it on my machine. Now this may, again, take a little while depending on how big the application is that that you're installing. But as you can see, that was relatively fast. It went ahead and created a launcher now for Internet Explorer under my Video Dude Applications CrossOver folder. So it gets me a launcher. And similarly, if I were to take a look at the file structure for this new bottle, IE6, I'll open it up in our Finder. Lo and behold, under Library Application Support, CrossOver, Bottles, yada, 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 we now have an IE6 bottle with all of the associated file structures around that. So that's how you get archives on and off of your machine using the Bottle Manager. And again, very convenient feature for being able to move applications around and back them up and that sort of thing. Thank you for your attention.